Let's discuss the electric field strength due to a uniformly charged rod. There are two cases we'll discuss, in which as a case one, we'll discuss the electric field strength at an axial point of the rod. Say we are given with a uniformly charged rod, which is say positively charged, with a charge Q and it is of length L. And on this axis of rod, we are required to find the electric field strength at a point P located at a distance R from one end of the rod. Now in this situation, we know well as the rod is positively charged, electric field strength will be having a direction towards right because it is always away from the positive charge. If we wish to find out the value of electric field strength, as it is a distributed charge, we consider a small element of length dx on the rod. And on this element of length dx, say the charge is dq. And as this charge q is uniformly distributed on the length L, it can be written as q by L dx. Now, due to this dq, electric field at point P is having a strength D, then this D can be given by the result of a point charge, that is K dQ by x square. So we can write net electric field at point P can be given as, this can be written as E is equals to integration of D, that is integration of K dQ, we can substitute as Q by L x square dx. And for this rod, the limits of integration for x we can substitute from r to r plus l. So this will be integrated from r to r plus l. So in this situation, the value of electric field will be here kq by l are constant. So this will be integration of 1 by x square dx integrated from r to r plus l. So this will give us kq by l. Integration of 1 by x square will be minus 1 by x, and we substitute the limits from r to r plus l. So this electric field at point P that is located on the axis of rod at a distance r from one end is given by kq by l. After substituting the limits, we'll get 1 by r minus 1 by r plus l. That will be the result for the electric field strength at an axial point of a uniformly charged rod. Now, if we continue with the second case of electric field calculation for a rod, that will be at an equatorial point, which is a point on the perpendicular bisector of the rod. Say, again we are having a uniformly charged rod, which is charged with positive charge uniformly. Say the total charge on it is Q and the length of this rod is L. And say on its perpendicular bisector, at a distance R from the center O of the rod, there is a point P where we wish to find out the electric field strength. We proceed in the similar way. At a distance x from the center, we consider an element of width dx on which charge will be dq, that is q by L dx. And due to this dq, electric field at point P will be in the direction away from the point charge dq, and say it is having a magnitude d. Then in this situation, we can write electric field at P due to dq is, this d can be given as k dq by this distance square, which is root of r square plus x square. You can calculate by Pythagoras. So this will be r square plus x square. Now in this situation, when we integrate this result from one end of the rod to other end, the direction of electric field will be changing from left to right. So in this situation, as a vector is changing its direction, it is advisable to first take the components. Like if this angle is theta, this will be theta, the electric field will be having a horizontal component d sine theta, and it will be having a vertical component d cos theta here. So here you can state, when we integrate this electric field from one end to the other, this d cos theta will all be summed up and d sin theta left and right components will cancel each other. So we can write net electric field at point P is given as, this net electric field can be written as Ep is integration of d cos theta only, as we know that all sin theta components will cancel each other. So in this situation, if we substitute the values, d can be written as k dq dq, we are having q upon l dx, r square plus x square multiplied by cos theta, and this triangle cos theta we can substitute as r by root of r square plus x square, r by root of r square plus x square, and as we need to substitute the limits of integration on x, x is taken from the midpoint, so its limits will be substituted from minus l by 2 to plus l by 2. Now in this situation, we can see that k, q, r by l are constants. So in this situation, we are having this integrand to be dx by r square plus x square to power 3 by 2, which will be integrated from limits minus l by 2 to plus l by 2. And now in this situation, this is a standard integration. When we just substitute the value of this integration, this will be kqr by l, and this integration will be x upon r square multiplied by root of r square plus x square, and limits will be from minus l by 2 to plus l by 2. When we substitute the limits and open it, on simplifying this result, finally we are going to get 2kq divided by, this will be r root of 4r square plus l square. That will be the result we are having. So this will be electric field at an equatorial point can be given as 2kq by r root of l square plus 4r square. That will be the result.